Hello everybody, I'm Jordan Laub, and welcome to yet another episode of Trojan TV. Our big story today deals with COVID-19 and the degree to which it continues to be a concern internationally as well as in our local community. This past Tuesday night, December 2nd, the Andover COVID Response and Assessment Team met virtually to make the recommendations on the current levels of infection in the district. Color-coded in severity from green to yellow to orange to red, the team voted to remain in the orange zone. The vote was a solid majority with 65% voting to remain orange, 22% voting to go red, and the smallest number of 13% voting to return to yellow. Currently, the Andover District student infection rate is 2.3%, while the staff infection rate is twice that at 6.9%. Next up, Mitchell Hansen introduces us to the competition between two very popular gaming systems that continue to raise the bar in technology.
Video games have made a huge impact on some of our lives, whether it's through esports or just enjoying a Friday night. Companies have been battling for the best gaming console for years. Recently, Sony and Microsoft released their newest editions of their consoles. Sony released the PS5 with a price of $500. Microsoft released the Xbox Series X, also with a price of $500. If you do not yet have these consoles, you probably won't have one for a while. They are sold out everywhere in the nation, with both planning to release more as the year comes to the end.
Thanks, Mitchell. Finally, we're pleased to provide you with the inside look at another Andover High School creative mind with our second edition of Humans of AHS.
Hi, I'm Vincent Lee. I'm a senior at Andover High School, and I've been here throughout the entirety of high school. So, in truth, I haven't been really active with other school activities, but there is one school activity that has piqued my interest, and that's art. You see, art to me is very fun to make. It's something that can just move beyond on what can typically restrain somebody. Like, physically, I'm not strong. Intelligently, I'm not that smart, but with art, I could just do whatever I feel like. And if it looks pretty to me, then I'm happy. The art I specifically make is based off any interest that I have at the time. But most of the time, I do have the interest of post-apocalypse from the media that I enjoy, like video games or movies. The things that I make typically have gritty, rustic, metallic looks. Typically robots that have humanoid figures, because that's the funnest to make. But the movies I enjoy typically have a lot of animation within them, and I enjoy watching the process and just the general look of animation because of how fluid it can be, how breathtaking it can be. It's so very much interesting to see someone's work just evolve and just enrapture people from what they can make. And that's something I want to make one day. In truth, I may not fully want to be an animator, but instead I would like to go into animation myself, not for a business, but for what I can do. That's really something that just makes people smile. And I want to do that with what I make. And so with my career indulgence, I might be able to do it.
Thanks for watching. Again, be safe, mask up, and we look forward to bringing you some sports updates in our next episode. I'm Jordan Laub, and I'll see you next time.